In this video, we are going to solve problem 2-103 from RC Hibbeler Engineering Statics 12th edition. According to this problem, if the resultant of the three forces is Fr equal negative 900 kLb, determine the magnitude of the force in each chain. To solve this problem, first of all, we have to find the coordinates of the contact points. First point is point A. I can locate point A from the origin with the help of a position vector. The position vector has one component parallel to the y-axis and one component parallel to the x-axis. Now this angle is 30 degrees. Why? Because the angle between x and this position vector is 120 degrees and we know that a quadrant is 90 degrees. So 120 degrees minus 90 degrees is equal to 30 degrees. So the x component would be negative because it is moving in the negative x direction, 3 sine 30 degrees, comma y component would be 3 cos 30. It is positive because it is in the same direction as the y, positive y axis, comma 0. It has nothing in the z axis. Now for the coordinates of point B, again I have to locate the point B with the help of a position vector like this. Now this angle is also 30 degrees because of the same reason. Why? Because the x-axis and the position vector B are forming 120 degrees and a quadrant is 90 degrees. So if I subtract 120 and if I subtract 90 from it, then I have 30 degrees. This 90 is representing the angle between x and y axis. For the point B, I have same negative 3 one component parallel to the y-axis and one component parallel to the x-axis, negative 3 sine 30 comma 3 cos 30. But this time this y component is negative because it is in the negative direction of the positive y-axis, comma 0. Now the coordinates of point C, if I locate it from the origin, then point C is only lying on the x-axis. It has 3 in the x-axis and 0, comma 0 in y and z-axis. Now fourth point is point D. Its components are 0 in x and y and 7 in z axis. Now these are the components. Now these are the coordinates of the points. These will help us to solve our problem. Now to find forces FA, FB and FC, I have to resolve them into their components. For FA, now FA is equals to its magnitude and its direction. Now we are going to replace this direction by the unit vector from A to D, which is in turns equal to position vector RDA over its magnitude. Action vector UAD is equals to RAD over its magnitude. Find the position vector. I have to subtract the coordinates of point D from the coordinates of point A. This is point A, this is point D. So I have negative 3 sine 30 minus 0 I plus 3 cos 30 minus 0 j. Plus 0 minus 7k. I have to divide it with their magnitude. It's negative 3 sine 30 whole square plus 3 cos 30 whole square plus negative 7 whole square. So UAD equal to negative 0.197i plus 0.341j minus 0.919k. If I put this value into this equation, then fk is equal to negative 0.197fai plus 0.341FAJ minus 0.919FAK. This is the vector FA into its components form. We have to repeat the same process for the force FB and FC. We have to repeat the same process for the forces FB and FC. For FB, FB is equal to its magnitude times its direction. Unit vector FBD. Equal to RBD. Its magnitude. Coordinates of point B minus coordinates of point D. So these are the coordinates of point B, point D. Negative 3 sine 30 minus 0 I plus negative 3 cos 30 minus 0 j plus 0 minus 7 k divided by magnitude. It's negative 3 sine 30 whole square plus negative 3 cos 30 whole square plus negative 7 whole square. So F, I am writing it directly, is equal to negative 0.197 FBI minus 0.341 FBJ minus 0.919 FBK. Now this is the vector FB into its components form, or you can say that it is in Cartesian vector form. Now, for FC, same process will be repeated for the force FC. At U CB, it's UCD. UCD is equals to position vector RCD over its magnitude. We have 300 and 007, a minus 0 I plus 0 minus 0 j plus 0 minus 7 k divided by 3 square plus negative 7 whole square. So fc equal to 0.39 fci minus 0.919 fck. Find the resultant of these forces. I have to sum them up. So fr is equals to fa plus fb plus fc. FRX, resultant of the forces in the x-axis, equal to 0. I have, because the resultant is only acting in the z-axis, negative z-axis, so I have to consider this force component, and this force component. It's negative 0.197 FA minus 0.197 FB plus 0.39 FC equals 0. Let's call this equation A. Similarly, I have some of the forces in the FRY is equal to 0. I have negative 0.341 FA minus 0.341 FB, and here is no Y component, equals 0. From here FA is equal to FB because these two will cancel out. Let's call this equation B. From the third equation, now this is not 0, this is equal to negative 900, because it is given in the problem that the resultant is 900k but in the negative direction. So I have negative 0.919 FA minus 0.919 FB B minus 0.919 FC equal negative 900. Let's call this equation C. If I put FA equal FB in equation A, then equation A would become negative 0.197 FB minus 0.197 FB plus 0.39 FC equals 0. From here FB equal to FC, which means, let's call this equation D. From equation B and D, I can conclude that FA is equal to FB is equal to FC. Now I can call it in general as F. Now consider equation C. I can replace FA, FB and FC with F in equation C. If I take out 0.919 as a common, then negative 0.919, it will become FA plus FB plus FC equal negative 900. I can replace FA, FB and FC with F. 0.919 f equal negative 900. So f is equal to 326.44 lb. So our result is fa is equal to fb is equal to fc is equal to 326. lb. This is our answer. I hope you will find this video helpful. If you do, please feel free to subscribe this channel and also turn on the bell icon for daily updates. And if you have any queries about this problem, then you can write them down in the comment section and I will be happy to answer them. Thank you.